What is the Lion King? It is the representative symbolism, ladies and gentlemen. You'll see it in Las Vegas. As millions of people walk between the protective paws of the great lion of the MGM Grand Hotel daily and don't understand its meaning. The lion is facing directly the Luxor, or the source of light. It is the symbolism of the royal family of the tribe of Judah, the descendants of the house of David, that will rule the New World Order. Freemasons don't even have the slightest idea what they are a part of or what they are helping to bring about. I stand back in awe as I watch this and study it. And as my knowledge increases and I have a better understanding, my jaw drops to my chest in amazement. Absolute amazement. I don't know if I'm going to be successful in waking up anyone, but I must continue to try. For you see, once we really understand what's happening in this world and what's bringing it about and why, and once we understand that we can never cease studying and understanding and learning, no matter how old we get or how smart we think we are, once we understand that, that's the only time in our history that we will actually be free, even though we thought we were free on many prior occasions. None of us are free yet. Nor have we ever been. We've been pretty close to it. But somewhere along the line, we stopped thinking, stopped using our brains, began to be puppets. Someone began to attach strings to our hands and our arms and our feet and our knees and our mouth even. It is amazing. On the physical plane, folks, Freemasonry is the science of sciences, the supreme recognition of God as the artificer of terrestrial nature, but not the God of the Bible. Even though they have a Bible on their altar, that is not the God that they worship. Not at all. In the series Star Trek, which music I played at the beginning of this program, you'll hear again, Dr. Spock represented the illumined man, the man who worked from pure intellect. He was never wrong. And even though Captain Kirk was the commander of the Starship Enterprise, it was Dr. Spock who really controlled everything. None of you really understood that. But someday, maybe you will.